Mexican food. Neither chimichangas, fajitas, burritos, queso amarillo, refried beans, or cheese enchiladas. Even though I love them, but they're not Mexican. That's Tex-Mex. I'm not saying that Tex-Mex is bad. I personally love hard shell tacos, even though some of my people don't like them. Tex-Mex is often confused for Mexican cuisine. Tex-Mex is a mix of cultures. It's Native American, Spanish, American, Mexican, and it's wonderful. So you should know that Mexican and Tex-Mex are different in so many ways. I don't know everything about Mexican food, but I know a lot because I was born and raised in Atotonilco, El Grande Hidalgo, next to my grandma and my mom, always in the kitchen. Today, I'm the executive chef of Cantina Rooftop in New York City, and I also went back home to reopen my grandma's restaurant called La Única in Atotonilco, El Grande Hidalgo. Taco Bell was named number one Mexican restaurant in America in a recent national survey called Harris Poll. That's not true. Taco Bell, it's not Mexican, and I don't think it's Tex-Mex. I think it's something else. Taco Bell, you're good, but you're not number one. I'm sorry. There are no hard shell tacos, people, in Mexico. We have tostadas, flautas, and they're delicious. Some people think and they're scared of Mexican food because it's too spicy. That's not true, and it's not fair. Sure, we use a lot of dry chilies, but we use it for taste, not for heat. I personally use chile de árbol because it has a heat that you can handle, and it's not as crazy as the habanero. Okay, so in Mexico, we don't make as much flour tortillas as we do in the United States. Most of the tortillas that we make back home, it's made with corn. I believe there are 64 kinds of corn, and 59 that are native of Mexican corn. A lot of Tex-Mex recipes, they use a lot of cumin. We use cumin, but just a little bit. We also use a lot of herbs, epazote, papalo, romero, which is the Mexican cousins of the basil. We cook with whatever is on the local markets. My favorite thing about Mexican food is street food. Who doesn't like street food? It's the best Mexican food, but in small bites. In here in America, you have the ground beef taco, which is good. I like it, but I don't love it as much as tacos de cabeza, which is the head of the beef. It's steamed, and you can choose from the brain, the cheeks, the tongue. It's just amazing. And yes, we have quesadillas, but we don't use that much cheese because in Mexico, they're focused more on whatever it's the flavor of the quesadilla. If you want to make squash blossom quesadilla, you want to make sure you try the squash blossoms. If you put a lot of cheese, you will lose the flavor of the squash blossoms. So why we don't see these dishes on Taco Bell? If Taco Bell is a Mexican restaurant, I think what Taco Bell is doing and some other brands are taking Mexican food and commercialize it. And that's okay, but at the same time, we're losing our history, we're losing our culture, we're losing who we are as Mexican cuisine. I think part of the confusion of Tex-Mex and Mexican, it's long time ago, when I first started, I saw a lot of people playing safe, a lot of restaurants and chefs. They were used to put nachos on the menu, fajitas, burritos, so they can sell it and stay on business. So they were afraid of putting a huarache, a guisado de res, because people weren't familiar with it. A lot of people wouldn't take a risk. It's you as a customer wouldn't take the risk. And we as a chef, we're like, you know what? Why should I put a huarache on the menu when it's not gonna sell? When I can put a burrito and it sells. You know, besides those hard shell tacos, go and order a gordita with burrata. In our menu, we have gordita with burrata and heirloom tomatoes. So it's old school and new school. But don't be afraid, nothing's gonna happen. If you don't like it, you send them back. So chefs, keep trying harder. Customers, don't be afraid, and let's change this world for a better world.